Hello, my name is Michael Losier. I'm the author of the book Law of Attraction. You know, it's 1.9 million copies sold in 33 languages, so people are enjoying it all over the world. Today, I want to do a little introduction to the audio that you're about to listen to. It is step one of the three-step process in Law of Attraction, and today's subject is Law of Attraction for Abundance. You notice I'm not using the word money, but I'm using abundance. So how to use Law of Attraction to become more abundant. You know, I just want to briefly say my book, Law of Attraction, is divided into two sections. The first section is how to stop attracting what you don't want. And that's where a lot of people lie. You know, they have debt, they're not attracting money, they win money, they lose money, and a whole routine, they're all their vibes about money. You know, I'm going to make this really simple. You get what you vibe. You get what your vibes are. So if you have a negative vibe around money and abundance, guess what? That's what you're going to get. So my first book says, how do I change my vibe around whatever I'm wanting to attract? This podcast that you're about to listen to, how do I change my vibe around money? I promise you I can help you do that. The second part of this free audio is the three-step process in my book. There's three steps to do anything, to attract anything. If you want to become more abundant, you need to identify what that is. So with the worksheets, and here's a sample of the worksheet that you're going to use, the very first step, you're going to use a worksheet, and I promise your vibes are going to change around your abundant, your what you think about your abundantness, and then you're going to start to see results. The link to the worksheets is just down below the video in the description field at the very top there. We put the link to the worksheets. And for those of you that are so excited and stimulated and have so many results from doing step one, you can buy the entire three-set package of audio podcasts on the same link that's down below. Again, this particular series is becoming more abundant. And I'll give you a quick little secret about this whole series. Abundance is a feeling. And what I can help you do is use step one, two, and three to generate the feeling of abundance. And when you generate the feeling of abundance, the obedient law of attraction will respond to it and give you more. So enjoy today's recording and feel free to share with others so all of you can live a life of abundance. Good luck and have fun.
Hello, everybody, and good morning. It's Michael Losier, and today is class number one of the three-part teleseries on how to become more abundant using Law of Attraction. I'm so glad that you're here. I want to welcome Inner Circle members that have joined us today, and my Facebook friends and my Twitter friends and Law of Attraction certified facilitators and everybody that wants to know a little bit more, well, I shouldn't say a little bit more, a lot more about how to become more abundant, in particular around the subject of allowing. So for those of you that are familiar with my book, Law of Attraction and Law of Connection, you'll know that my style is the how-to guy. And my hunch is that you've had results in the past from working with me because I am the how-to guy and I tell you how to do it instead of just doing it. So becoming more abundant, well, how do you do that? Well, that's what we're going to learn quickly today. And the exercise is 15-day program. And I can promise you this. I will guarantee this. I will guarantee you'll become more abundant if you follow the instructions. How can I guarantee that? Well, it's the law. Law of Attraction states whatever you give your attention, energy, and focus to, you can attract more of it, providing you're allowing it. So that's what you're going to learn how to do. You know, we might not even mention the word money too often in this class because it's not about money. It's about becoming abundant and being abundant. You can have everything you want without spending any money on it. I know that might be a new mindset for some of you. Speaking of mindset, I'm probably going to end up challenging some of your belief systems around your worthiness and your availability to receive abundant things and or money. So just hang in there with me. If you know my style, you know that I'll explain things if they sound new to you, and ideally you'll embrace them, and you can move on with this first 15 days. First thing I'd like to do is I'd like to hear from a couple people, but what was it that you brought you to this program today? What are your expectations? What do you know about it? I'd like to hear from three people, stating your first name first. Who'd like to go first?
Sandra.
Hey, Sandra, go ahead, please.
What brought me to the class was just seeing the word allowing.
Okay.
I want to work on my allowing.
Okay, working on your allowing. Good. Thanks, Sandra. Who else?
I'm Michael. It's Adriana.
Hey, Adriana. Welcome and go ahead.
So what brought me to the class is that as an Inner Circle member, you know, I've been doing some of your techniques and it's working, but I got some things that are not there yet, so I want to tweak what I'm doing.
Okay, good. Just some more tweaking, some more education,
yes.
Some more new stuff on allowing, okay?
There's something that, you know what I mean.
It's a process, right?
Right.
Good. Thanks, Adriana. And one more person. Who'd like to go next?
This is Pat.
Hey, Pat. Go ahead and welcome.
Thank you. I'm a part of the Inner Circle also, and things are manifesting, but in a smaller way than I would hope for. So
okay.
I want to learn how to think big.
Okay, very good. Well, thinking big is one thing. How to allow bigger is what we really want, right?
That's it.
I'm allowing bigger. Well, good. Thanks, Adriana and Pat. Well, good morning, everybody. And ideally, you'll have the worksheets in front of you. Some of these might be familiar to you if you've been to my seminar. Today's focus is all about becoming more abundant. You're going to learn the secret to that. We're going to start talking about allowing. I'm going to give you some homework for the next 15 days. And I promise you, in the next 15 days, you're going to have stories to report about your abundantness. How do I know that? Because I'm going to influence your abundantness today. Say yes if that's okay.
Yes.
I'm going to influence it today. As a matter of fact, it's going to be permanently changed today. Your attitude, which is your feelings and your mood about being abundant, will get shifted today. Very good news. Okay, we're looking at the handout from the top of page 2, and you know the definition I attract to my life and business, whatever I give my attention, energy, and focus to, whether negative or positive. So underline the word negative a couple times. Boy, that was the big shocker for me when I learned about law of attraction, because I understood that when I have positive vibe, I attract positive things. Boy, I'd brag about that. Say yes if you do too.
Yes.
And then when the ugly stuff shows up, it's like, why is this happening to me? Why would the universe bring me something negative? And as we all know, the universe or law of attraction is obedient, and it has a job description that's only two words long, which is match vibrations. That's what it does. It's a vibration matcher, period. Whether it's negative or positive. Law of attraction doesn't have a brain or a consciousness. It doesn't decide. It doesn't make decisions. It doesn't have favoritism. It's not prejudice. It is obedient. So, on this worksheet, where you see the equal sign, I want you to write, a vibe equals a mood or a feeling. You know, whenever I use the word vibe, I'm really talking about, you know, I'm talking about the vibe in this room, where he's giving off a vibe, or she's giving off a vibe. I'm always talking about the mood or the feeling. But the word vibe comes from what longer word?
Vibration.
Vibration. So the second equal sign, right, a vibe equals a vibration. What I'm doing right now is kind of demystifying the word vibration because it sounds fun and giggly. And what does that mean? Well, a vibration is simply a vibe, and a vibe is simply a what? A mood or a feeling. So here's my skill testing question. When do you have a mood or a feeling?
All the time.
So right now and right now and right now, and even if you don't even know that you are, and even if you deny having one, right now you're all having a mood or a feeling, and it's either negative or positive. And guess what? Law of attraction is in your house, and it's in your car, and it's in your bedroom, and it's in your world, and it's eavesdropping on the vibration and matching it. So my job is to teach you how to be a deliberate sender of vibration so you can become more abundant. And that's what this program is, to give you the tools to do that. Now, you see negative and positive. Let's talk about abundantness and money and that whole field. What are some negative emotions that we might have about that? Let's shout out four or five different negative emotions around money and abundance.
Not enough.
That's negative. What else?
Stress.
Yeah, when I'm stressful, that's a negative vibration about money. What else?
Fear.
Lack. Desperation. Debt. All of those words create negative vibrations. Now, positive vibrations. What moods or feelings about money and abundance come from positive vibrations?
Freedom.
Freedom.
Belief.
Relief.
Abundantness. So, at every moment we're having a mood or a feeling about anything, in particular about abundance and money, we're having that mood or feeling. Law of attraction is matching it. So in this case, you don't always get what you want, you get what you vibrate. You know, you're saying you're wanting more money, but then you have doubt and negative vibrations about it, which cancels the desire of it. So we're going to clean that up today. Where it says at every moment, I'd like you to write this. At every moment, law of attraction is responding to my vibration by giving me more of it. Whether negative or positive. somebody read that back for me?
Law of attraction.
Go ahead.
Law of attraction is responding to my vibration by giving me more of it, whether negative or positive.
That's right. That's what it's doing right now. Whether negative or positive, it's matching it. So the reason why I'm telling you that, because it's important to know that it's being matched right now, whether you're doing anything or not on purpose, it's matching it right now. Now, earlier I said, or I didn't say, but I'm going to say it now, if you're curious and you want to know what your vibration is about abundance, you're thinking, I wonder what my vibration is about abundance. Well, you just have to take a look and see what you're getting. But I'm going to describe now with the words and the results, the relationships on the next part of the worksheet. So we have boxes 1 to 4. In box number 1, write the word words. So it's like a box. It's a big box. It's a box of words. The box underneath the right words, write this question. What words am I using? What words am I using? Okay, so we just have a box of words. Now I'm going to reach inside the box of words. I'm going to pull out a bunch of words, and that brings me to box number 2, which is thoughts. So those words that I was thinking have created a thought. So the question underneath the word thoughts is, what thoughts am I thinking? Now you notice I don't even have to be saying these words out loud, because law of attraction doesn't have ears, and it doesn't have eyes. So it's not reading what I'm reading. It's not listening to what I'm saying. It's not hearing what I'm saying. It doesn't respond to any of those things. Law of attraction responds to how I feel about what I say and think. Write that in the margin somewhere. Law of attraction responds to how I feel about what I say and think. Anybody feel relief about that? You don't have to write it down. You don't have to make a collage. You don't have to tell 10 friends. You don't have to visualize it. It's how you feel about all of those things. This is going to play a significant role over the next 15 days for you. So box number 1 is I have my words. Box number 2 is that I have the thoughts that are made up from the words. Now I have the thoughts. I'm thinking a thought, and what does it cause me to send?
Vibration.
That's right. Let's go to box number 3, write the word vibe. In the box below it, write, what vibes am I sending? What vibes am I sending? Now, you can always tell what vibes that you're sending by how you what? How you feel. Oh, I'm feeling pretty crappy right now. I'm feeling like I'm in debt and I got money problems. Well, if that's what I'm, let's walk backwards. If that's the vibe I'm sending, where did it come from? Well, it came from the thoughts that I was thinking about all those things. Well, what was inside the thoughts that caused the negative vibe? Well, it was the words. Say yes if this pattern makes sense, yes or no?
Yeah.
So I can tell by the mood that I'm in and back up, oh, I'm in a pretty happy mood. Oh, where'd that come from? Oh, I'm having happy thoughts. Why? Because I'm using words that are creating them. That's the pattern. But with law of attraction, there's a step further. People sometimes say this is positive thinking. You know what? A positive thought can have a negative vibration. So box number 4, after I'm sending a vibe, law of attraction, checking and matching it. So in box number 4, rather, I get my what?
Results.
I get results. And beside the word result, draw a little positive or negative symbol. And in the box underneath it, write, my results equal my vibrations. My results equal my vibrations. So let's take a look. Let's walk backwards. Now, it might not be you, but it could be somebody you know that takes a look at their finances or their job. They're not getting paid enough, or they're feeling they're overworked, or they're not charging enough. I mean, there are so many different reasons why people would have those feelings. That's the results that I'm getting. How come I'm getting such negative results? Let's walk backwards. The reason why you're getting those results is because you had the vibe, and the reason why you had the vibe is because you had the thought, and the reason you had the thought because the words you used. So when you walk backwards, you can see that the words you use are actually creating the results that you're getting. Write this in the margin. The only way to change results is to change what? Back up one box. The only way to change results is to change
vibrations.
Very good. That's what you're going to learn today. And the only way to change a vibration is to change what? Thoughts. Your thoughts. And the only way to change a thought is to change the words. Good. Let's go to the top of the next page. There's a round button there. You've seen it before. Inside the button, write the word reset. So we just drew a reset button. Say yes if you love a reset button.
Yes.
So you're thinking, you know, and that's what my job is over the next three classes, and your homework is to help you reset your results. So let's go back to the page two. Let's go to box number four. I want to reset my results. If I want to reset my results, I need to reset the vibe that I'm sending, because that's the only way to change my results. And if I want to reset the vibe that I'm sending, I need to reset the thoughts that I was thinking that caused me to send the vibe that caused me to get the results. But I've got to go one step further. I got to change the words that I'm using in my thoughts. So that brings us to the next page again. I know that you know what they are. What are the words that are creating those thoughts?
No, not don't.
Yeah, don't, not, and no. That's the words. Let's go to the next page. Write that at the top. Don't, not, and no. I know that you know what they are. Don't, not, and no. Now, this is the first part. This is, you know, we're talking about allowing tools. I'm calling this allowing tool number one. You know, I've read other law of attraction books, not fully, or articles, and other trainers and other methods and so on, and a lot of people are skipping. Well, you know what? Almost everybody is skipping the first step in the whole process, and the first step in this whole manifestation process is to stop attracting negative things. I can promise you it's almost impossible to attract abundantness if you have a negative vibration around you. You see, the negative vibration is diluting the positive vibration of your abundantness. So we have the first part of the whole exercise is stop eliminating these three words, because these three words are causing negative vibration. When I use the word don't, not, and no, whenever I say the word don't, not, and no, I just gave attention. So when I say, you know, and here's the, and I know people say, what if you say you don't have money? Will I attract it? No. Law of attraction isn't responding to the words you're using. It's responding to how you feel when you say that. Does that make sense, everybody? It's responding to how I feel about that. So the first part of the alignment tool is to eliminate and practice the elimination of the words don't, not, and no. And the correction sentence, the reset sentence underneath it is, so what do I want? So what do I want? Now, I'd like to hear from a couple people that have learned this and that are practicing this, and tell me what changes it's made for you. I'd like to hear from two people. Who'd like to go first? Regarding the correction of the don't, nots, and nos, who'd like to go first?
Michael, this is Lucinda.
Oh. I heard Lucinda and then Adriana. Go ahead, Lucinda.
Yes. I think the number one thing that's helped me in terms of eliminating don't, no, and not is that I switch to a positive vibe and switch to a positive feeling much more quickly than I used to.
Okay. So are you finding that you're resetting in the moment?
Yes,
yeah.
Much better at resetting in the moment, and or if I am in a cranky space,
yeah.
Once I actually decide to get clear with what I'm wanting, it moves faster.
Yeah, good. I mean, that's a good point. You know, I get cranky. I get ticked off, too. So it's the question is, well, how long am I going to put up with that? Because Law of Attraction doesn't know I'm Michael Losier and then I wrote the book, right? It's thinking, oh, it's eavesdropping in my vibration. Oh, here's a negative vibration. What do I do with it? I'll match it. Oh, I didn't know that was Michael Losier. I don't care. He's got a negative vibration. Let's match it. So this ability to reset from going from don't, not, don't, what do I want, is really important in the allowing process, because it's getting rid of the negative vibration. You know, I want to talk about allowing before we move on. Well, first I want to hear from Adriana and then talk about allowing. Adriana, tell me what you've noticed once you've learned the elimination of don't, not, and no.
I've noticed it a lot. I attracted a lot, big things as well as little things. And what I really liked was just, so what do I want?
Yes.
I even put it on stickies in the office.
Yes.
To remind myself.
Okay. And I know your husband practices this material. So are you catching each other saying don't, nots, and no's and gently reminding the reset sentence?
Absolutely, and actually we practice it at home in trying to, in the way we talk to our family,
yes.
To our children. You
know, okay.
We, you know, utilize it at home in our,
yes.
With our kids.
The family that vibrates together stays together, so that's a good deal. Okay, every time we use the word don't, not, and no, in that very moment I'm going to ask myself, so what do I want? And the next sentence on your worksheets, when the words change, the vibration changes. Write that down. When the words change, the vibration changes. So now I'm holding a new vibration, and now it's the vibration of what I want. And I'm thinking, so what do I want? Now I'm thinking, well, I'd like to be abundant. I'd like to have more freedom. I'd like to be able to take vacations. I'd like to be able to take 4 days, have a day off a week, or whatever that vibration abundance is for you. But here's the good news. Next sentence, I can only have one vibration at a time. I can only have one vibration at a time. Say yes if that's good news.
Yes.
Yeah, so now I'm holding the new vibration of the way I want it to be. Law of attraction, checking and checking and checking. Law of attraction doesn't have a memory of us. It doesn't, I'm using the word does not on purpose, it does not have a file folder or a record or a memory and thinking, well, you know what, Adrienne and Michael were positive yesterday. No, it's only matching the current vibration. This is why it's important to know I can only have one vibration at a time. So a lot of you have done this exercise already. I want to spend 15 minutes on it. It is critical and important that you reduce and eliminate negative vibrations. So somewhere on your worksheet, draw another circle the size of a golf ball, maybe beside your reset button. Inside the golf ball, write the three words, don't, not, and no. So you have a circle with the three words, don't, not, and no. Now put the international do not use symbol through there, like the no smoking symbol. I'm doing that right now. Now burn that image. Look at it. Burn it in your head. Burn, burn, burn. Every time you go to use the word don't, not, and no, in that very moment, you're going to say, so what do I want? And when you go from what you don't want to what you do want, the words will change and the vibration changes. And now law of attraction is responding to the new vibration. So this is part one. This is part one that's critical. It's not taught very often, and it's really important. The first step is stop attracting negative vibrations. And negative vibrations always come from negative thoughts and negative feelings and negative circumstances. So we want to reduce all of that stuff. Which brings us to the purpose of the class now. It is to deliberately attract something. Now, let's talk about the distinction between law of attraction and deliberate attraction. So law of attraction is existing right now. Do you have to do anything to tap into it?
No.
No.
Yeah.
I mean, some people aren't doing anything and they're manifesting things, both negative and positive. Sometimes I hear people say, oh, law of attraction worked for me last week. I found a $10 bill. Well, you know when all the crappy stuff happened last week? That was law of attraction too. So the whole notion, the whole shift here that everything you're attracting is because of law of attraction, whether it's negative or whether it's positive. So when you take a look at your finances and your abundance, the same thing. It's because of law of attraction. It's because of these two kinds of vibrations. And you're not even doing anything. But what we're learning how to do is become deliberate attractors. And the key word in being a deliberate attractor means you need to be doing something what?
Deliberate.
Because law of attraction is already existing. It's already eavesdropping on your vibration. And how can you tell what the vibration is that you have about abundance and money? How can you tell that? By what you're getting. Hey, if you like what you're getting, celebrate it. Get excited about it. And in your celebration and excitement, it causes you to send more of the same vibration, which causes you to stay in the vibration that you're in if you like it. But we're resetters. We know how to reset. It's again, I don't like my abundantness. I'm always scraping for money. I'm always, you know, money comes in one hand and out the other. Whatever the story is, you know, that story we tell, does that story cause you to send the vibration of the story, yes or no?
Yes.
I did a radio interview yesterday, and we had a caller on the phone, and he kept telling the same story. He told the same story three times, and I said, well, I've already heard this story three times. When are you going to change the story? But it's my reality. It's my reality. It's like, you know, they're not getting it. It's like, yeah, you know what your reality is? Your reality is whatever is real for you. If you don't have any money and your life sucks, that's your reality. Why would you want to go to reality? It already sucks. I might be the first person to tell you guys to become unrealistic. Stop focusing on reality. If your reality is that you're not abundant, why would you want to go to reality? Become unrealistic. Write that down. Become unrealistic. You know, if you're in business and you're not getting enough clients right now, then you're getting three clients. What's your reality around the number of clients you have? Three. What would be unreal number for you? Seven. Did I say impossible? No, I just said unreal. It's not real for you. So become unrealistic. Everybody appreciating the play on the word here? Yes or no?
Yes.
What about reality? Hey, your reality sucks, buddy. Why would you want to go back to that? Become unreal. That means pick something that's not real for you and then tap into law of attraction. That's what we're going to do. So there's three steps on how to tap into law of attraction for those of you that know my work, have heard them before. The first step is identify my desire. We're going to work on that today. What do I want? what would be ideal for me? How do I want that to be? Well, you'll see that in a few minutes. So that's the first thing. We're going to build a list of what we want. Step number two, give my desire attention. You're going to be doing that for the next 15 days and maybe for the rest of your life when you see the results. So step number one, identify my desire. Step number two, give my desire attention. And step number three is allow it. On the bottom of page three, I'd like you to write this. The speed at which law of attraction will manifest my desire is in direct proportion to, I'll say all that again, the speed at which law of attraction will manifest my desire is in direct proportion to how much, somebody finish that, how much I am
allowing.
Somebody read that sentence back for me.
The speed at which law of attraction will manifest my desire is in direct proportion to how much I am allowing.
Thank you very much. Hey, wouldn't it be nice if it was in direct proportion to how much I wanted it? Or how many people I told, or how long I visualized? See, that's what we're doing, aren't we? We're spending too much time in the desiring phase. In other words, we keep ordering this vibrationally. It's like placing an order for a pizza. We've ordered a pizza, and we ordered it again, and now we're calling three pizza stores. Now we've ordered four pizzas, and they're coming to the door, and we're not letting them in. And now outside my door is all the stuff that I've ordered physically or vibrationally, but I'm not letting it in. That doesn't make a lot of sense, does it?
No.
So we want to learn how to – well, we do know how to place a vibrational order. We're going to get clear about what we want today. We're going to give it attention, energy, and focus in the next 15 days, and then we're going to sit back and wait for it to come? No. We're going to open the door. We're going to learn how to allow it in. I know allowing can be kind of an evasive word. There's lots of ways to describe it. I like to make stuff really easy. What does allow it mean? It means allow it in. You ordered it, now allow it in. You know, everything that we've been ordering vibrationally is just stockpiling. It's out in your hallway right now, out in the backyard waiting to come in. So you don't need to place more orders. You need to accept the order that you placed. And that's done through allowing. And that's what this program, because I know you're all good at desiring money. You're going to have lots of fun, excitement, playing with your abundantness. But if you don't know how to unlock the door to allow it in, then you'll just be where you're at. But that won't happen because you're here on the call. Very good. Who has any observations, comments, or feedback about that little three-step piece before we move on? Anybody have feedback or comments about that?
I like the visual things at the door, constantly ordering things at the door and not opening it up.
Yes.
I really like that visual.
Yes. Well, it doesn't really happen to me as far as the pizza goes. But, you know, let's pretend you're going to order a pizza. Do you tell the pizza people all the things that you don't want on your pizza?
No.
No. So we're pretty good at identifying what we want on our pizza. And then we place the order. In other words, when we did the phone call or ordered it online or however we did it, did we press enter to place the order? Yes. And that was giving it attention. So I decided what I want, which is step one. I gave it attention, energy, and focus by placing the order, and now I'm not letting them in. So we're going to learn how to do that. We're going to learn how to open the door to allow in what it is that we ordered. Very good.
Great.
Anybody else have comments or feedback about this piece?
This is Penny.
Hey, Penny.
I just think that it's good news. It's good news that we're going to be able to now open the door and let it in.
Yes, thank you. It is good news. And you know what the good news is? It's you can do it on your own. I was going to say it doesn't cost anything to learn it, but you're paying for this information. But once you know, this isn't a one-time shot. This is tools that you'll have forever to learn how to do this. And not just for abundance, but all the different allowing. You're going to learn lots of techniques all around allowing. Okay, very good. Let's go to page number four. I'm calling this tool number two, for allowing. And what this tool will do, it's going to help us shift our vibration. Now, you know, some of you probably had been to the doctor and you got blood results, right? And the doctor send you a blood report and says, here's your blood results, and we get excited. We all look at my blood pressure here. This blood test is good, and this is good. We call that a blood result, you know, your blood work. But we're going to find out what your vibrational report is. We're going to go to the vibrational doctor, and we're going to order a vibrational report because I'd like to get a scan of my vibes. Would you, yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, I wonder what my vibes are about abundance. I'm going to go to the vibrational doctor and get a quick little scan. Oh, look, it's on page 4. I have to do an intake form before you see the doctor. This is the intake form, and we're going to do part of it together. The very top of the page 4, it's step number 1 called Identify My Desire. It's going to be the second tool in helping you allow because it's going to help you shift from what you're getting to what you want. It's called the Clarity Through Contrast Worksheet, and where it says My Ideal, you can put My Ideal, you could put My Ideal Financial Situation, or you could put My Ideal Abundance, whatever word works for you, My Ideal Financial Situation, My Ideal Abundance. Now, I have 10 items on this sheet only because it only holds 10. Somebody finish this answer and finish this sentence for me. The more contrast that I come up with, the more what I'll get?
Clarity.
The more clarity. So we're just going to do 4 or 5 together to help you walk through the example. So I'd like to hear from 5 different people, and it might not be you. Tell me something that you don't like that you're receiving around abundance and money. Who'd like to go first?
This is Penny.
Hey, Penny, go ahead.
I don't like credit card debt.
Okay, so too much credit card debt. So number 1 is too much credit card debt. Good. Number 2, what else?
The past.
Hey, Pat, go ahead.
How about the past?
Oh, what about the past?
History with money.
Okay, and more specific, what about it?
Probably not feeling worthy of making more money.
Okay, not worthy of making more money. Good. Thanks, Pat. Next.
Michael, this is Latrell.
Hey, Latrell, welcome.
I would say with me, I want to make more money in my business.
Right, so that's what you do want. So what's the contrast then? Not making enough money?
Yes, I'm making enough money in my business.
Okay, not making enough money in my business. Good. Couple more.
Sandra.
Hey, Sandra, go ahead.
Stressed when paying bills.
Stressed when paying bills. Okay, my hunch is there's one more. Who's that?
My abundance might sound odd, but, you know, I'd like to attract more single available men.
Okay, so number 5 is, I would put that under a worksheet for your ideal mate. But it's still a good one to, yeah. And that'll need more clarity than available single men, trust me. Because that's not a vibration. I know lots of available single men. They're, you know what, they're not very nice. So you want more clarity. So that's a perfect reason to do a Clarity Through Contrast worksheet for that. So you know what, it's not you, but somebody just, you know, the doctor just knocked on the door and handed me their vibrational results. And I'm thinking, okay, Bob, here is your, we got the printout of your vibes for abundance. Too much credit card debt, not worthy of making money, not enough money for your business, stressed out when paying bills. That's the vibe that Bill or Bob is sending. Is that what they want?
No.
No, but that's the vibe they're sending. That's their blueprint. Let's call it a vibrational blueprint. Write that down somewhere. It's a vibrational blueprint. And in brackets, put story. This is the story. Oh, yeah, money comes in one hand, out the other. I mean, would you really put that on your bathroom mirror?
No.
Yeah. I take 2 steps forward and 1 step back. So these things that we say carry a vibration. So that's in the box. It says, what are the words that I'm saying? What are the thoughts that I'm thinking? What's the vibe that I'm sending? Now, we want to go from contrast to clarity. Let's do this. So, we're going to go to the clarity side by asking that oh-so-famous question, so what do I want? So, number 1, too much credit card debt. So what do you want? Anybody?
Debt.
Well, zero debt. Go type in zero debt on the internet, and what will come up?
Debt. Okay, got it.
Good. So if you don't want to have debt, what do you want? And that's not a bad thing, by the way. It's how you reframe that. Boy, I loved getting a loan to buy my condo. And I'm in debt for it, but it feels good. You know, I owe somebody money for it. It could turn to cash if it had to. So if you don't want credit card debt, what do you want?
Financial freedom.
Okay, let's put that. Financial freedom. Any other words we can add to that? Financial freedom.
Minimal debt.
Well, minimal debt is still debt, right? It's a tricky one. It's like saying you don't want to date a smoker, but you still said smoker. So let's play with this. How can we word this so I don't have any debt?
Michael, can you use the word, can you say debt-free?
Well, if it feels good, you can do it. You know, remember, law of attraction doesn't care about the word debt-free. It's how you feel about that. But there's still that little niggling with the word debt in there. So financial freedom. I'm going to put just the surplus of money. Now, I don't know if that means $1 or $10, but at least it's indicating there's no debt. I'm just going to have a surplus of money. Let's cross off number one on the left-hand side. We're done observing that. Number two, not worthy of making more money. So what do you want?
Worthy of receiving
money. Let's attract opportunities to receive more money for my energy. Yeah, if you're charging your clients and you're going to raise your rate, well, you might lose a client that didn't pay your rate, but there's new clients that'll match your new rate. So you want to attract opportunities to receive more money for your energy. Somewhere in the margin, write this. Money is an exchange of energy. That's all it is. You know, in the olden days, I would give you a dozen eggs and you would give me two loaves of bread and we'd be happy with that, right? We'd do a barter. And then, you know, I'd sell more eggs and somebody would give me, some beef and some vegetables. And after a while, it's like, okay, I've got a lot of eggs here and I don't need to be trading. I think I'll use money instead. So the money became the form of exchange. And we're the ones that have to decide what the exchange is, the worthiness of that. So that's where that conversation comes in. So number two, not worthy of money. We're crossing that out. Not making enough for my business. So what do you want? How about a profitable, energetic business? If those words work for you, I'd like a profitable, energetic business.
Profitable.
Yeah, any other words? Profitable, energetic business?
Thriving.
Thriving's good, okay. Thriving, add your own words, good.
Enjoyable.
Enjoyable, okay. Okay, let's go to the next contrast. Stressed when paying bills. That's what you don't want. What do you want?
Happy to have more than enough to pay the bills.
Okay, that's close. Yeah, good. We're still paying bills. Here I want to say acknowledge the receipt of services and pay with gratitude. I know that sounds funny.
Bill for services, eh?
Yeah, acknowledge the receipt. Wow, you know what? You know, I live in Victoria, so it doesn't get very hot or cold here, so we don't even have air conditioning. But over the winter, I have a fireplace that heats up. It's a gas fireplace. So I use the fireplace, and then I would get my bill in the mail. And I know some people pay an extreme amount of money for heat, but it's not really cold here. So it was like $100, and I thought, wow, I paid $100 for the month of December, and it was so warm in my house, and I had the fireplace on. I love that. What a great deal that was. You see how I'm reframing that experience?
May I share something?
Yes, go ahead.
When I received my receipt of service in the mail, now they changed the words for me, I always write thank you, balance zero, on every one of them. I always say thank you, and I always like just put balance zero.
It very
makes
good.
Me feel so good.
Okay, so this is solidifying my point earlier. It's how you feel about what you do. So if you say, oh, I love this zero balance and it feels good, then say I love this zero balance, right? What I want everyone to get in this call, in this series, is that Michael Losier can't tell you how you should feel. You all understand that? And that's why earlier when we were using words, I said, oh, that word feels good for you, then you use it. And that's what my job is to have you come up with the words and the processes so when you use them, then you feel good about using them. So if you fold that page in half so you're only looking at the right-hand side, I mean, this was only five. No, I think it was only four. This was only four pieces of contrast that birthed this clarity. My ideal financial situation in abundance. I have financial freedom and a surplus of money. I attract opportunities to receive more money from my energy. I have profitable, thriving, energetic business that's enjoyable. And I like to acknowledge the receipt on services when I pay my bills with gratitude. Hey, folks, that was only four pieces of contrast. Say yes if it feels different.
Yeah,
and you're thinking, oh, how's that going to happen? Guess what? You're not there yet. You're not there yet. You're only on step one. So step one says, identify my desire. Would you say that we identified your desire through this?
Yes.
Yeah. So that's your homework. And remember, the rule is the more contrast, the more clarity. And then build a list and actually type it out. Does law of attraction care if you type it out?
No.
But what will it do typing it out? What will it do when you type this out?
It reinforces.
It reinforces it. Will you give it attention, energy, and focus? Yes.
Yeah.
Everybody go back to the page before and look under the vibe box. The rule's simple. In order for you to become more abundant, you need to be sending the vibration of abundance. So in the vibe box, you know, in my book, I talk about the vibrational bubble and how we have a bubble, and that's all of our vibes are inside of that. There's not really a bubble. I'm just teaching and pretending. So we need to be very conscious about what my vibe is, and that vibe comes from the words and the thoughts that I'm using. And that's this desire statement. You know, law of attraction doesn't know I was just teaching that. You think law of attraction was eavesdropping on my vibration when we got to the clarity side? Yes, even on the contrast side. And law of attraction doesn't know I'm teaching you. So you know what? I'm benefiting from teaching the class. I just gave abundance, attention, energy, and focus. And law of attraction doesn't know I was teaching it. Are you understanding my point that I'm making? Yeah, when I was doing more one-on-one coaching in the past, I'd be working with people that want to attract more clients, and we'd be doing allowing for a half hour on the phone, and I'd hang up the phone, and I'd have people that wanted to hire me. I'd literally hang up the phone, and people would say, hey, I just stumbled across your website, or I was at a, whatever, and it's like, oh, look at that. Law of Attraction didn't know I was helping Betty. It was picking up on the vibration that I was sending when I was helping Betty. Hence my policy not to help people get pregnant, okay? You want to get pregnant? You can go see someone else. But that's my point. You guys probably noticed that too. As you were doing things, as you were helping your friend, you'll say, oh, isn't that funny? I was just talking to Bob yesterday about this, and now I attracted it. Has that happened to you before?
Yes.
You know why it came to you really quickly and not Bob?
Because we were in alignment?
Yeah, well, you didn't have any doubt or resistance to receiving it. Bob did. That's why he's not getting it. Very good. Okay, I'd like to hear two people comment. What is your observations? What are your comments or feedback on the Clarity Through Contrast worksheet? And then we're going to move on. Who'd like to go first?
Marina.
Marina, welcome and go ahead, please.
I think you have to allow. Like, that's the big lesson is learning how to allow.
Learning how to allow. Okay, good. We're going to talk more about that shortly. Marina, thank you. Who else? Sandra, go ahead.
I just love the way you've worded the clarity portion. I've updated, you know, my previous contrast worksheet.
Okay.
I'm going to use some of the words that you used.
Oh, good.
Good.
Well, thank you. It takes practice to do them that well. I'm going to use the word not. I'm not new. I'm not new. That's what I tell my friends. I'm not new. Okay, good. So let's recap again. You know, the tool number one was learning how to reset from don't, not, and no's. And I promise you when you shift your don't, not, and no's to what do you want, that'll make a significant difference. It'll open up the crack of the door so you can start allowing. Because remember, the shroud of negative vibration that's around you and us is the one that's stopping the door from opening. So we're going to look at that. We're going to start to open that door a little bit through tool number one, which is the don't, not, and no. Tool number two is let's shift my vibe about money. You know, when you did this exercise and when you do your own contrast, that's your homework, is to add more of your own contrast, then you're going to have a beautiful desire list. That's the first part of the process. Now we're going to move to page five. Now, at the top, it says abundance. I'd like you to write this. Abundance is a feeling. Abundance is a feeling. So you're saying, so what? Big deal. Why do I need to know it's a feeling? Well, guess what you're learning how to do? You're learning how to be a deliberate sender of vibrations. Let's go back to the four boxes again. The third box, which is the vibe box. What if we could stand in that vibe box and send the vibration of abundance? What will law of attraction do to it?
Give us more.
So the importance for you to understand that abundance is a feeling. And why does that matter? It's because we are in the business. We know how to generate feelings. You know, people always want me to have a deck of cards and all kinds of law of attraction stuff. And frankly, it's not really interested in products and stuff like that. But I thought if I ever did a charade game, you know, when you play charades, you pick a movie title and you pick all kinds of different titles and you act out actors in movies and so on. What if I had a deck of cards that just had feelings on it? And we pulled the anger card. Could I generate the vibration of anger in a room? You bet I could. People say, you can't make me feel anything. Oh, yes, I can. I can I make people feel anything, even if they say that I can't make them feel something? How would I do that?
Words.
With the words. Oh, let's pull the next card. It is the pride card. Can I generate the word? Can I generate the feeling of pride within people? Or how about the acknowledgement card? Or how about the bliss card or the love card or the disappointment card or the rage card? Here's my point. Can I duplicate a feeling, yes or no?
Yes.
And it's done through my what?
Words.
Words and thoughts. So let's go to box number three in the word vibe and put the word abundance in there. This is the secret to this whole program. Is that you're going to be deliberately sending the vibration of abundance, because abundance is a feeling. And we know that law of attraction is in the business of matching vibrations. Somebody finish this sentence. The only way to become more abundant is to send the vibration of
abundance.
Write that down in the margin. The only way to become more abundant is to send the vibration of abundance. Hey, the only way to attract an ideal client is to send the vibration of what?
Ideal client.
Ideal client. The only way to attract your ideal boyfriend or girlfriend is to send the vibration of what? Good. Say yes if you're getting the importance of understanding that abundance is a feeling.
Yes.
Yes. And here's, you know, there's all kinds of good news, but a real good part of this news is that law of attraction doesn't know how it got in your vibration box. I wonder why Michael's sending the vibration of abundance. I better check the rule book. It doesn't, because law of attraction doesn't have a brain, and it doesn't have a conscience.
I didn't get the whole sentence. The only way to become more abundant.
The only way to become more abundant is to send the vibration of abundance.
I just want to make sure I wrote it down.
Okay, no, that's good. So that's what you're going to be in the business of doing, of being more deliberate about sending the vibration of abundance. I'd like to hear two people out, your observations, comments on that subject so far. Is that a new idea, a new concept? Have you been practicing it already? Who's got a comment?
This is Penny.
I heard from Penny and then Marina. Go ahead, Penny.
I think it's just good to know and realize that abundance is actually a feeling,
yep.
Not just a, yeah.
Okay, good. So knowing that it's a feeling is helpful, good. And Marina, what's your comment?
It's amazingly powerful. I witness it all the time, and I revel in it, and
yes.
I reset.
Very good.
By going back to those good feelings, and then it's amazing. You get even more. Like it's shocking.
Yes. Well, you know what? Instead of saying it's shocking, and I can't believe it because I know we do that, right? So I want everyone to draw a circle the size of a golf ball and write this. I can't believe it's happening. Inside the circle, write, I can't believe this is happening. Now draw the international do not use symbol through that. And here's the new expression. I think Adriana might know it. Adriana, what's the new expression when we say, I can't believe this is happening?
I can't believe it. The other one is
I love it
when this happens.
Thank you, whoever else said that. I love when this happens.
I love when this happens.
I love when this happens. Instead of saying, wow, is this ever freaky? I can't believe I got this. Is this, you know, because we do that. I did that. And then I thought, okay, you know what? I love when this happens.
It's So, Michael, on that note, since you started telling me, because I was making that error quite often.
Well, it's not an error. It's just a correction.
I've gone on like this attracting tons of abundance lately, big things and little things. So I was telling my husband that we've been doing the gratitude journal, and it's been wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm really looking forward to these 3 weeks. So.
Okay, good. Okay, thanks. Anybody else have a comment before we move on? Okay, let's do it. So, abundance is a feeling. That's your mantra for between now and the rest of your life. And if we go back to the four boxes and we want to attract the results of abundance, I need to be sending the vibration of abundance. So the next exercise on page 6, which is the next allowing tool, is to help us identify what it is that we're attracting already that we could call ourselves abundant. Because you know what? A lot of you are already abundant, but you don't even know it. Like you're not acknowledging it or celebrating it. So somebody give me an example of something that you received today or yesterday, maybe for free, that has a financial value on it. You could say, wow, look what I attracted. Am I ever abundant? Who'd like to go first?
This is Penny.
Oh,
I heard from Penny. Go ahead.
I was treated to a nice dinner last night. It didn't cost me anything, and
okay.
I was so grateful.
And did somebody drive you there?
No, I was already there.
Okay. And did you get any free coaching or advice over dinner?
Actually, I did that.
Okay.
I offered that to them. So
okay, good.
Abundant for them as well.
Okay, so we're on this page, and one of those boxes, I want you to write dinner. And if you know the price, sometimes that could help. Law of Attraction doesn't care if it was a 50-cent donut or a $50 steak. But you would say, I was treated to. So what else happened yesterday, Penny, that you could say that you were abundant because you received something that had a value to it like that?
Yesterday, today. Well, you know, I can tell you today I have a friend here working in my garden actually right now as I'm on this call. So that is total abundance for me. Yeah.
So you're having free gardening labor?
I'm getting landscaping done for free.
Wow, you're ever abundant. So look at that. Yesterday you got a free dinner, and now you got landscaping. So put those in two separate boxes. And this is what your log is going to look like over the next 15 days, and you're probably going to need two or three worksheets. When you celebrate the dinner and when you celebrate the lawn, and what do I mean by celebrate? That's a funny word. Somebody give me a couple definitions for celebrate.
Grateful.
Be grateful. What else?
Acknowledge
it.
Recognize
it. Yes, good. These are all good words. And sometimes the word celebrate sounds like having pom poms on and jumping up and down. It's like you don't have to do that. You could say, "Wow, am I ever abundant?" I mean, last weekend I was in Vancouver. I met this multi millionaire, and I went to his place and he took me for lunch and he was quite interested in my business and on and on and on. It was a friend of mine that set it up. And the whole time I'm thinking, wow. And we're at this little lunch restaurant, and I said, am I ever abundant? My friend brought me here. My friend brought me to this guy that's a multimillionaire in Vancouver, and now we're at this restaurant, and my friend's buddy is going to end up paying for the lunch because I heard him say that already. And he's giving me, and I'm just going through in my head. I'm thinking, wow, am I ever abundant? I mean, and it never cost me anything. That's my measurement. It's never cost me anything. And then I end up flying to Vancouver on a little seaplane. And I've been doing it so long, and I never really checked my points balance. And every time I fly, and I looked at my points balance, I literally had like 1,000 points, which means I spent $1,000 flying from Victoria to Vancouver. And I end up taking me and my friend to Vancouver and back on points. And when I went to get our seats, there was a seat sale for the weekend. So it used to be $150 one way, and now it was $42. And I mean, I was so full of myself over this dinner. It was like I was kind of like an overwhelm. It's like, oh, am I ever abundant? Like, and to me, that's kept me in the vibration. And celebrating means acknowledging and talking about it and keeping score and counting. Thanks, Penny. Let's hear from somebody else. What are a couple things that you can put in your tool number 3 box? Who'd like to go next?
It's Marina. I've got a question.
Yes.
Can you ever be overabundant?
Can you be overabundant? I don't know if you can be overabundant.
You just said you felt overabundant, so I'm kind of curious. Can you ever be overabundant?
I don't know if I said overabundant or maybe overwhelmed. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, overwhelmed, the feeling. It's like, whew, it's like I have to catch my breath. It's like, whew, this is happening fast. Or the time I'm staying at the Omni Suites Hotel where the guests of Oprah Winfrey stay, and then I get into the hotel room and there's a big basket and a bottle of wine and there's a nice note there saying that, you know, I can call this limousine service to take me anywhere I want to go and I can order from the hotel, and it's like, you know, and I'm before I go to the Omni Suites Hotel, because when I worked for Oprah I had to go to Chicago a few times, so I'm going to the store and I'm buying water at the store and I'm buying snack, you know, little power bars and stuff, and thinking, you know, because one thing I don't like to do, and I use the word not at a hotel, is pay $8 for a bottle of water. I'm just not doing that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm in the Omni Suites Hotel, and I read this beautiful welcome letter from Oprah staff saying all the benefits of staying there. And there'll be a car to pick me up in the morning to take me to the studio and all that. And I was in overwhelm there. I start to cry, and it's like, I never been in all of that opulence before. And I was by myself, which was not ideal for me, but it was like, that's what I mean by overwhelm. I was like, whew, this is big deal. And then I get into counting, and then I said, wow, and then I'm taking a shower and noticing everything there and then getting dressed and waiting for the dry, and it just goes on and on. And I'm keeping a tab in my head. I said, you know what, just to get to Chicago to film 4 radio shows cost about $5,000. Can you imagine that? $5,000 for me to go to Chicago to record 3 or 4 one-hour shows. That's the abundance that Oprah has. Like, there was, it was, as far as the budget, it didn't matter. Whatever it cost to bring me to Chicago and put me up and pick me up at the airport and pay me to do every show, it just, I mean, that's overabundance in a good way. It's a good use of abundance. Another thing you guys will start to learn if you haven't already, giving stuff away can also make you feel abundant, but only when it feels good. Everybody understand that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I think I wrote an article about tithing, and, you know, tithing, with all due respect, is something that a church created. And they say if you tithe 10%, you'll get that much more back. You know what? Law of Attraction doesn't know about math. That's, in my opinion, that's not true. So tithing, you will get more back when you tithe, providing one condition. What is it?
That it feels good.
It's like, you know what? Because I tithe a lot. I give a lot of services away. I give coaching away. I take people's calls. And I always feel good about that. But when somebody calls me and say, oh, can I pick your brain? I don't like that. You know, that's not me giving of myself. That's somebody taking from me. So it's just different language and different wording. So tithing will help you vibrationally only when it feels good. And, you know, and only do it when it feels good, and only donate stuff when it feels good. And not, if you do it out of guilt and shame, then that's a negative vibration. Okay, we're going to hear from somebody else about what did you attract yesterday or the last couple of days that you could put on your log for today. Who'd like to go next?
Sandra.
Hey, Sandra, go ahead.
I got free Cinemax and HBO for the weekend.
Okay, so free HBO, Cinemax, that's good. What else?
And this call is wonderful.
Okay, although it wasn't free, but you're getting lots of free advice. Yes, and you'll have other things.
I got an escrow refund that I wasn't expecting the other day.
Okay, good. Now, another little tool that I might teach you later on is, have you cashed the check yet?
No, I haven't.
No, I'd keep it in your wallet for a few days. Why would you do that?
It sounds like I would get it until... and get the feeling of abundance.
Yeah, I said, look at me. I mean, sometimes we don't need to cash that check right away. If you can keep it in your wallet for a few days, and every time you notice and say, look at this, I got this much money coming, I love that, I love it, this is going to convert to cash when I need it, I love having this abundantness. And so putting it in the bank right away, even like getting when you get paid through your job, direct deposit, it's okay, but it's nice to have the check. And, you know, sometimes in the past I would display my checks on my desk and put them in a row when I was first starting out and get all excited about that, really noticing that. So if you don't have to cash the check right away, keep it inside your wallet for a bit. Okay, Sandra, say that again.
Sorry. That's Marina. What I find works is actually nowadays you can check your balance at the bank very easily along
yes.
the line.
Only if it feels good. Yes, check your balance, print it off. Good. Okay, let's hear one more person. What's a couple of things that you've noticed that you've attracted? And then we're going
to
wrap up.
This is Anne. I attracted a free trip to China.
Okay, well, good. That must have a value attached to it for sure.
Yes.
Good. Okay.
So three buckets from the pizza place for watering my garden.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, there's a value to that, too. Like, you're all going to be so surprised what you can deem as being abundant, you know? You know, it's just... And really think about services, because people will do stuff for you that you have to say, wow, that's a service. I mean, did somebody give you free advice or free coaching, or did somebody help you with your garden? Did somebody take your garbage out? Just think of that as labor resources. The game here that you're playing is to be in the vibration of abundance more often. And when you start to notice things every day that you're abundant, so here's a math question. 5 minutes of sending the vibration of abundance is better than what?
Zero.
And the only way to attract anything is to send the vibration of that which you want to attract. So I'll make this promise to you again. You do this homework between for the next 15 days, at least until next Saturday, and ideally you'll have lots of things on your list. And every time you write it on the list and every time you think about it and you go back to the list again, is it helpful to add on to an existing list?
Yes.
Yes, you'll say, holy poopers, look at me. I'm on item number 99. Is this ever awesome? This has only been in the last 5 days.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I want to sign off today with one more thing that you need to know about allowing. Underneath the on page 5, where it says abundance is a feeling, underneath that sentence, write, allowing is the absence of doubt. So when do I really allow something? Well, when I doubt it, when I get rid of the doubt. Oh, I'd like to become more abundant, but I doubt it. But what's the best way to remove doubt?
Find proof.
That's right. Write this down. The best way.
So, Michael, can you repeat that sentence again? You said allowing is the...
Allowing is the absence of doubt. D-O-U-B-T. That's my Canadian accent. Allowing is the absence of doubt. And the next sentence, the best way to remove doubt is to find proof or evidence. They mean the same thing. So, we heard Adriana write down two or three things on her list, and Santa wrote down two or three things. So those things are proof of your abundantness. You might not even consider yourself abundant. Say yes if you didn't really consider yourself abundant until this exercise. Okay, well, that's a good sign. So that's what your going to be deliberate effort is to notice things that you can celebrate as being abundant. And then when you're building the list, you'll look at it and say, you know what? I am abundant. And it's not an affirmation anymore. It's a declarative statement. And in our next class, we're going to talk about why affirmations might not be working and how we want to learn to make declarative statements. So here is your homework. Complete the clarity through contrast list with your contrast about abundance. The next exercise is on a daily basis on page 5. I want you to fill in the blanks, and if you need more worksheets or whatever, do what you need to do to print this page off or do it on your own computer, and do this for the next 7 days. And my hunch is you're going to have a lot, and you're really going to notice your abundantness, and you're going to be in the vibration of abundantness, which is going to – what you're really doing here is exercising your abundant muscle. So here's how I'd like to end the class. I have 10:04. I'm 4 minutes over, and ideally, this is being recorded. Diane will send it out, so if you have to leave or left, that's okay too. But I would like to hear from as many people as we can in the closing. What was one thing that you got today that was your aha moment or your something that excited you, something you see yourself doing? What are your thoughts about today? Remember to state your first name. Who'd like to go first?
Elenitsa,
go ahead, please.
I like the what you said, become unrealistic. It's something I want to teach all my clients.
Okay, good. Become unrealistic. And I think there's an article on my website, Elenitsa, under the articles,
yes,
that you could get to support you with that too. Good stuff.
Thank you.
Who's next?
Penny.
Hey, Penny, go ahead.
I think it's very powerful to list all the different ways of abundance. So this list is going to be very helpful.
Okay, it will. It'll be vibrationally helpful too. Thanks, Penny. Who's next?
Sandra.
Hey, Sandra, go ahead.
I love the statement, money is the exchange of energy.
Okay, money's an exchange of energy. I love that, too. Good. Who's next? Two more people.
Dale. This is Dale.
Hey, Dale, go ahead.
I just wanted to back up what the lady said just a few minutes to, or a couple seconds ago, I really like the idea of making the list because it just really helps me to celebrate the abundance, like help us to recognize, and the more you feel abundant, the more you bring into your life.
So that's right. And that's what we're doing. We're being deliberate about feeling the vibration of abundance. And the nice thing about it, you don't have to get the feeling of abundance. You just are in the feeling of abundance. Like, you don't have to make up the feeling. It's a true vibration. Thanks, Dale. And two more people. Who's next?
Michael, this
is I heard from Elenitsa, and then who was after Elenitsa? Sorry, not Elenitsa. Okay, go ahead.
Shannon,
go ahead.
Okay. So I like the pivoting. Like, instead of saying, I can't believe this is happening, I love it when this happens.
Okay, the reframe, yes. Good.
Thank you.
Thanks, Shannon. Who else?
Latrell,
go ahead.
Okay, I like the way he said the best way to remove doubt is to find proof or evidence.
Okay, good. So you're going to be a proof seeker this week.
Yes.
Good. And one more person. Who's that going to be?
Marina.
Hey, Marina, go ahead, please.
I like to reframe on it because I am very abundant when it comes to money. I'm a money magnet right now.
We love that.
And it carries on. It's fabulous.
Good. Well, nice to have you on the call. Well, thank you very much, everybody. I had a great experience today. You've got some homework ahead of you. You're going to be more deliberate. Remember box three, the vibration. What are you sending? What are you thinking? What are you saying? What's your blueprint? This is a time to change all that. This is the good news. We have the ability to reset what we thought. But you know what? We need more proof. And that proof will become our new belief. And the new belief will become louder and stronger than the old belief. And that's the nice thing about a belief. It's just the thought that you think over and over and over and over again. So let's say goodbye. I'll hear from everybody next week. Thank you very much for attending and being so participatory today. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Goodbye. Thank you.